Hello and welcome to the Noble Leaders Cup. I am Kjotleik. This is the first qualifying round and we are starting off with Aegimius of the Dorian Greeks and Mihirakula of the Heftalites. Aegimius is spiritual and organized, and the Dorians start with fishing hunting. Mihirakula is aggressive and imperialistic, and the Heftalites start with hunting and mining. Starting positions on the map, let's get the resource bubbles on for a moment. This is Aegimius. He starts up here. There is some fish, there are pigs, and there is some copper. All the way in the north, next to a river, there is very little land. He has only one way to expand, and that is southeast. All the way at the bottom of this continent, we find the starting position of Mihirakula. He has a lot of crabs around, there is horses, some fish up here, there is silk. Now, let's see what's going to happen. One of these are going to get eliminated, and the other is going to qualify for the second qualifying round. The game is afoot. And this time, there is no time. Let's just get it rolling, shall we? Off we go. There is no time limit in this game. They will have to reach a victory condition. If it has not been reached until turn 500, we automatically go into overtime, extra time, call it whatever you want. Two cities each, Aegimius in Hinduism, Mihirakula doesn't have any religion yet, Buddhism, yeah, both have founded their each religion. This is win or get knocked out. There is no second chances here. This is a cup competition. Only one chance to make it count. And we have the first war already. Turn 129 or something. Six cities, Mihirakula. Four, Aegimius. Looking at this, Aegimius is weaker than Mihirakula. But Mihirakula with six cities, Aegimius with four, and the war is raging, let's see. There is also going to be, Mihirakula is going to get catapult soon because he is on construction, Aegimius going for metal casting. It looks to me like no cities has been lost yet. Four cities, Aegimius, Mihirakula six, turn 175. This was not meant to be a peaceful game, I guess. They have no touching borders, but they are fighting, and they haven't been taking a city in a very long time, and there is the peace treaty as well. Five cities now for Aegimius. The Dorians, they are doing it. Coming back in the city count department, and also equal in strength with Mihirakula. Let's see what we can do. Mihirakula now up to seven cities going for engineering, and Aegimius is actually stronger now, even though it's going only for machinery. Eight cities, Mihirakula now six for Aegimius. Next war is breaking out, and both of them, Mihirakula just got engineering, Aegimius is trying for it. Eight cities now, 2-6, 8-5, Aegimius has lost a city, Mihirakula has raised it. This is crucial, Aegimius is down to four, and this is the Heftalites that has the advantage, 10 cities to four. It looks like Aegimius may be eliminated from the... eliminated from the cup as the first leader, because Mihirakula now is up to 12 cities, Aegimius on 5. Both of them are trying to go civil service, and even though Aegimius got it first, he is in a lot weaker position than his opponent right now. There is no more land to be had in the old world, so they have to go out and settle the new lands, but I don't think that that is going to happen, because here we have the next war. Aegimius is 0.8 the strength of Mihirakula, and he has only 4 cities, Mihirakula 13, which means that the Heftalite leader has a lot more cities to produce units with. Aegimius down to 3 cities, Mihirakula is on his way to be the first leader to advance into the second qualifying round, and 4 cities. It is Aegimius now, 12 Mihirakula, he took one back there. Suddenly turn 268. I don't think that we are going to need overtime in this game, it seems. turn 272, but 5 cities Aegimius now. Mihirakula is down to 12. Mihirakula and Aegimius is up to 0.9, the strength of Mihirakula as well, but now Mihirakula is going for gunpowder. Aegimius is going for the guilds though. But gunpowder for the Hefta Light Leader now. 5 cities Aegimius, 12 cities Mihirakula, and now gunpowder is here for the Hefta Lights. Aegimius with 5 cities, can he really come back from this? He was down to 3 cities and now he's back up to 5. Now he's back down to 4 again. The war is on, turn 293, 4 cities left for Aegimius. I had written him off before when he had 3 cities, now he's up to 4. It looks to me like this, it should be over. Let's see what Mihirakula can do here. 13 cities to 4. Aegimius is now trying to go gunpowder as well, but with only 4 cities to produce units from. Peace treaty. 3 cities left for Aegimius, 14 for Mihirakula. And this must have been the decisive war, isn't it, though? This could very easily now just be one more war declaration and we could see conquest. We are at turn 3, 1, 5, 14 cities to 3. The peace treaty is still in effect, but there it is no longer in effect. So let's see when the next war is breaking out. Well, already now, of course. Optics for Mihirakula. Aegimius is trying to go astronomy, but with 3 cities left, I doubt he has the production capacity to take advantage of that even. Education next for Mihirakula then, 14 cities to 3. I am looking at that number now, trying to see if he drops down to 2. He hasn't. Aegimius only 0.4 the strength of Mihirakula now. Still on 3 cities now. Turn 3, 3, 2. This is interesting. Mihirakula, can you get it? But now it looks like Aegimius is actually building more units. He was, well, he is losing them now. Down to 2 cities now suddenly. Down to 2 cities and Mihirakula is up to 15. Turn 3, 3, 9. This is not going to be a particularly early win, but it's going to be a win. Turn 3, 42. 2 cities left for Aegimius, and this is probably the first and the last time we are looking at the Dorian Greek leader 2 in this competition this season. Mihirakula, we are probably going to see again in the second qualifying round, and then he will be only one game away from the first round proper of the Noble Leaders Cup, turn 350, and there it is, a newly settled Dorian Greek city all the way down to the continent in the southwest. But he's down to 2 cities because he lost another one up there in the starting continent. So 16 cities for Mihirakula, 2 cities for Aegimius. Now 3 cities for Aegimius. He is starting to settle the new world, the new lands. He is holding on. Mihirakula needs to go down there to the southwest in order to take him out, in order to win conquest. Turn 366, Mihirakula with the Golden Age as well, 18 cities now for the Heftalite leader that has taken out all the Dorian Greek cities on the starting continent, but 2 cities for Aegimius on the continent down southwest, and that's going to help him stay in the game for a little bit longer, but we see Mihirakula is now also expanding into the new world. He has taken up that continent that is in the to the east and northeast. 19 cities now, Mihirakula. Turn 380, and this is going towards, well, if he doesn't care about overseas invasions, maybe it's going to end up a domination instead of a conquest. I was so convinced that this was going to end up a conquest. For a very long time I thought that was it, but now Aegimius is down to 1 city and this is going to be a conquest, because now Mihirakula has taken his boats and ferried his units over, and there is 1 city left for Aegimius, turned 390. And it looks like Mihirakula is now about to secure his place in the second qualifying round. Turn 393, and there it is. Conquest victory for Mihirakula. Congratulations. Turn 394, 1974 AD. And Mihirakula of the Heftalites is the first leader to advance to the second qualifying round in the NLC. there were 5 wars declared, 2 by Aegimius, the first two, and 3 by Mihirakula. However, Mihirakula of the Haftalites did win all 5 wars, even the one he defended. So congratulations to Mihirakula going through to the second qualifying round. Let's go take a look at the statistics then. These are the graphs. Aegimius is in the orange, Mihirakula is in the darker brownish. Score. GNP, we see he took the lead towards the end there, Mihirakula. Manufacturing was pretty even and he took the lead. Food, you can see, was better. Power, he was better most of the time at least. Culture, oh, that must have been a couple of culture bombs, right, to get him up above. And espionage, there he was actually below until the very end. Let's see the demographics. Aegimius, he was conquered, so he has no cities left, but he does have 109,000 soldiers. Mihirakula, then, these are the numbers, and these are the record per now in the cup. Let's go to top 6 cities and wonders. And see the wonders, there were 1, 2, 3, 4 wonders in the BC era, and we see that Mihirakula also controls all the 6 cities, of course. Statistics then. Aegimius, 11 cities built, 3 religions founded. In his cities, he did build 8 granaries, 7 lighthouses, 4 Dorian barracks, and we see some wonders here. Stonehenge is there. Let's go page down to see. The list ends with the pyramids. Let's go back to the top and see his current units, which is 1 musketman, which means that he should not have lost yet, but as we all know, conquer all the units, and that doesn't really work in the game for some reason. Trained in the cities, 60 spearmen, 50 macemen, 40 archers, down to 1 great spy. His kills then are 41 trebuchets, 16 chariots, and 15 hunas, down to 1 galleon. The losses, 61 macemen, 59 spearmen, 56 longbowmen. Let's take a look at Mihirakula then, the winner of the game. 15 cities built, 4 razed, 4 religions founded, 2 golden ages. Currently 35 windmills, 29 farms, 26 towns. He built in his city 17 barracks, 16 tents, and 13 stables. Assistant chapel is there. Let's go page down to see the Mahabodhi as the last item on that list. Okay, go back to the top and look at the current units. 43 longbowmen, 40 cuirassiers, 34 musketmen, and down to 1 great artist. And it trained a total of 52 trebuchets, 36 longbowmen, 35 cuirassiers, 7 ships of the line. Let's go page down and see that there is a spearman at the bottom. The kills then, let's confirm those. 61 macemen, 59 spearmen, 56 longbowmen, down to a workboat, and the losses, 41 trebuchets, 16 chariots, 15 hunas, and we see all the way down to a caravel. Let's go take a look then at the victory condition screen. Here we see the numbers of the game on the victory condition screen. Mihirakula got 45% of the land area, which was not enough to win domination by a mile. His cities are not anywhere near close to culture, but he did build the Apostolic Palace. Let's go take a look at the cities. And as we can see, Aegimius doesn't have any cities, so we are going to have to switch into Mihirakula. Okay. And then we are going to see the 22 cities of him. Let's sort by population. See that Sakala is pop 15, Hotan 14, Huanduris 12, and we see the numbers here on the screen. They are happy and healthy and have some food and have some commerce and building culture in Ambrakia, and otherwise a lot of units and stuff. Congratulations then, Mihirakula going through. And the next game up, we are going to have 2 games today because this is the first week. That's Afonso the First of Congo versus Mem Desa of Brazil. I hope to see you back for that one. I am Kjotleik. This has been the very first qualifying game in the first qualifying round of the Noble Leaders Cup.